Next, we have the judicial powers. Under the judicial power, the first point is impeachment of the president. The word impeachment we have already studied in the previous class. It is the procedure of the removal of president from his office. The parliament performs some judicial functions too. It has the right to remove the president from office through a procedure known as impeachment. You can underline these three lines. So it has the right, it refers to the parliament. Parliament has the right to remove the president from office through a procedure that is known as impeachment. Now, when does this impeachment take place? In case of violation of the constitution or grave means serious misconduct or behavior, either house, any one of the house, that is Lok Sabha or the Rajya Sabha, they can frame charges or they can level charges against the president. And if a resolution to this effect is passed by a two-third majority of total membership of the house and by the majority of members present and voting, the other house has to investigate the charges. If the other house too finds the president guilty, he may be impeached and removed from office. So now say, suppose Lok Sabha has framed charges, okay? It has leveled charges against the president and it finds that a president is not fit for his office. So two-third majority of Lok Sabha, they will pass a resolution and majority of the members present there, they will vote for the level of charge. So the other house, that is the Rajya Sabha, it has to investigate, it has to examine the charges given by the Lok Sabha. And if Rajya Sabha too finds the president guilty, he may be impeached or removed from the office. Next we have removal of judges, etc. The parliament can remove the judges of the Supreme Court and the High Courts, the Chief Election Commissioner and the Controller and Auditor General of India if they are found guilty of violating or breaking provisions given in the Constitution of India. Now a short note about Controller and the Auditor General of India. Okay, Controller and Auditor General, together they are known as CAG. Okay, and they are the financial, he is the financial officer. And the present Controller and Auditor General of India is Rajiv Maharishi. You can note down somewhere, girls. It is Rajiv Maharishi who is the Controller and Auditor General of India. Now this body, that is Controller and the Auditor General of India, it audits. Okay, it audits all the receipts and the documents, or you can say the bills and the expenditure of the government of India. I hope this point is clear, girls. Who is Controller and the Auditor General of India? So his main work deals with the, okay, this body deals with the auditing of the receipts and the documents or the bills, and they keep a check on the expenditure. Okay, they audit the expenditure of the government of India. Now next point is punishment. The parliament can punish a person for obstructing or interfering the work of parliament or showing disrespect to the house. In 1961, the parliament reprimanded or it expressed disapproval, or you can say scolded, the editor of the Blitz for ridiculing or using inappropriate language, using abusive language for a member of the parliament. Now these are the three points under the judicial powers of the parliament. First, we studied about the impeachment of the president. Second, the removal of judges, etc. And third, the punishment. Now we come to the electoral functions. The Indian parliament has to perform certain electoral duties as well, such as, first point, the parliament of India along with the state legislatures elects the president of India. So the parliament elects the president of India along with the state legislatures. Second point, the vice president of India is elected by both the houses of the parliament, that is Lok Sabha and the Rajya Sabha. Third point, the Lok Sabha elects its own speaker and deputy speaker. So we have already studied this, girls. We have speaker and deputy speaker for the Lok Sabha, and it can elect them from amongst its own members, while for the Rajya Sabha we have the deputy chairman, and Rajya Sabha elects its deputy chairman. So in our next class, girls, we'll continue with the amendment of the constitution. Good day.